Now may I invite Shri A.K. Khan sir onto the stage. Sir is an IPS officer of the 1981 batch. He's a gold medalist in chemistry, and then that was his master's, and he's worked on his PhD from the Indian Institute of Chemical Technology, Tarnaka, a very prestigious research institution. Sir's police career needs no mention, quite an illustrious one. The famed stints of being the Commissioner of Police in Hyderabad between 2009 and 12. I'm sure a lot of you know that. And sir has been, sir has been working for the past 3 years as an advisor in the cabinet and in cabinet rank for the government of Telangana. We all know that sir has an avid interest in sport. He not only watches sport, but has a keen interest in cricket and tennis. I still remember the cricket that you played, sir. It was an inspiration. So thank you so much for gracing the occasion.
I don't think that needs any reiteration, that idea. All of you know, it's not only the good life that it gives, much beyond. It gives you an excellent opportunity to lead a meaningful life, a life where you are in total connect with the society, the interactivity, etc. Otherwise, many who have done very well in other fields, they would not be attempting this examination. 2 years back, two or 3 years back, was Gaurav Agarwal. He was in the IPS. When I went to inaugurate some course there, he met me there. He told me that he's taking the exam again. He was already in the IPS. So he wanted some help. I invited him home. We sat down and had a couple of sessions of discussions. I found him good. In fact, you know his background. He was already in an international bank, posted in Hong Kong. His annual package salary was about 1.5 crores. He quit that without any support. In the sense, he just left it, came away, prepared for 2 years, and got into the IAS. He topped, like Anudeep did this year. Anudeep also was in Google. My son also was in Google. He also had a beautiful package. He had an offer of 96 lakhs per year package. But then I told him, you may get a lot of money there. You may not get 1/4 here when you join civil services, but your life will be definitely much better, much more meaningful if you join civil services. Please do it. He attempted, he got qualified, and all of us are happy for him. He's also happy. So money beyond a particular limit has no value. All of us should remember this. Life should be seen in totality. And that's where the civil services, Indian civil services, definitely count. It gives you tremendous opportunities to lead a very contented and a good life. So these are some of the things that I wanted to talk to you, a few stray thoughts. But remember another thing. When you start preparing for these exams, preparation looks very amorphous, disorganized. You don't know what you are preparing, why you are preparing. Because the syllabus, if you see, is very, very simple. Very simple, like British constitution, not like Indian constitution. It just says Indian culture. What on Indian culture, you do not know. In our times, Dr. Rao used to tell us, anything under the sun could be asked in civil services. Now we expand it further. We say under the sun, above the sun also is being asked these days. You don't know what really to prepare, what to get, what to write. That's why those of you who develop a proper attitude, proper approach, how to tackle the issues, so they will be very successful. Because tomorrow, when you become a civil servant, there are no two problems, no two issues that come to you are similar. You will keep approaching each issue based on what knowledge you have, and then what experience you have. Above all, how much of common sense and ideas you apply to tackle that problem, that issue. That is what UPSC is looking for in you. I remember two years back when I was in Delhi, I was sitting with Secretary DOPT. when I was there, 2-3 persons who were running very big coaching centers in Delhi, they had come to meet him. When he was speaking on phone, on their side I was asking, what do you think of the new pattern of examination, civil services? You know, one of them who is running the biggest coaching center in the country, you know which it is. So he was telling me, sir, UPSC's only aim, perhaps, is to run all of us who are running coaching centers out of business. That's the only thing they appear to be having in mind. That's how they're framing this sort of question papers, totally unpredictable, different, difficult, all sorts of. So that's why you must be prepared to tackle anything without getting ruffled, even sitting in the examination hall. So that sort of a preparation you need. This comes only through approach, through attitude, through originality, through innovation. I can tell you, my son, last time when he was taking this exam, he would take nobody's idea now. He said, enough is enough. 2 times I have appeared. He had got into central services earlier. But then this time I'm going to do it my way. I'll write it my way. If it comes, it's all right. Otherwise, I'm going to leave and then I know what to do. I'll go away and do something else. This time he wrote, he got a fairly good rank. All India 22 he got last year. So then what happened? I asked him, what is that you did differently this time? He said, knowledge-wise, there is nothing more for me to add, because what else could I do except adding a few things on current affairs, subject and other things. There's nothing that I could do. Only presentation I changed. Presentation also matters quite a lot. Same anthropology subject, which he had done earlier. Next year he did it with the same amount of information. This year he added in that subject alone 104 marks. 348 he got in anthropology this time. So he very plainly he told me that this is all that he did. On the interview day I was not with him. I had gone to attend some conference in Shimla, but evening I landed. I was very hesitant to touch him because he does not want me to talk to him about civil services at all. Even my wife, she like Saindhava in the Mahabharata. She would never allow me to go to his room. Just leave him, whatever he's doing, let him do. Don't go anywhere near him. Don't disturb him. Don't tell him anything. Your wisdom is 4 decades old. Don't try to tell him now. This is what she used to tell me. I also, parental concern would be there, but then what do? I could not do anything because neither he would listen nor she would allow me to talk to him. On that day evening, I took him on a walk to Lodi Garden after the exam. I asked him, how did you do? Don't ask me anything, that is over. He had one more attempt. I was slowly trying to suggest, why don't you just put the application, don't take the exam, just put the application and then leave it at that. No, if it has to come this time, it has to, otherwise I'm not going to write. This is exactly what he told me. Interview, of course, all the 3 times he did well. 213, 208, and 207. All the 3 times. This time also, he got 207 in the interview. In the top 10, he was always there. So, but this time, I was a little disturbed because he would not tell me how well he has done. He said, "It's over. Just forget about it. If it comes, comes. Otherwise, leave it." So, that's how exasperated a candidate becomes after going through this grueling journey called civil services preparation. So these are some of the personal experiences that I have. I have nothing more to contribute than to tell you, be prepared for a long haul. Try to finish it as quickly as you can. First attempt, second attempt, whenever you can. If you're taking more, be prepared to undertake that and do that. And do never try to mix it with anything else. Here, even when you have given 100% or more, there's no guarantee that you will get in. If you are doing anything less than that, telling that I'll do some private job, alongside I'll do this also, it doesn't happen that way. It doesn't happen that way. Give your 100% here. Even after giving 100%, there's no guarantee. Be prepared for that also. Okay? So mentally, be very, very tough. Mind also can be trained. As you can train your body, mind also can be trained. Train your body, mind, to be disciplined, to have right attitude, to think originally, to focus, to do everything. If you develop all those attributes, it not only helps you to crack this exam, subsequently when you join, and later, the center two seats where me and Goel Sahab are sitting, 3 decades later, you should also be sitting there and talking to the candidates like this. Wish you all the best. Have great futures.